Theme park enthusiasts often create lists regarding the best rides in their opinion, the best flat rides, best water rides. Mate, there's probably a best drinks at a theme park list somewhere. A lot of these lists stick to continents or even singular countries being lists of top 10s or top 25s. But today, I'm gonna push the boat out even more. In this video, I'm going to rank my top 100 roller coasters in the world. Please help me. Now, I have ridden more than 100 roller coasters, but I've decided to condense the list down so there's no piddly little kiddie coasters that, oh, look, it goes around a tiny little element. So the bottom 10 are the worst coasters I've ever ridden in my life, hence why the last 10 and the top 10 I'll go through a little bit more in depth than the rest of them. And if you are new around here and are interested in seeing content just like this, then please consider subscribing. It would mean the world. At number 100, we have the worst coaster I have ever ridden, Bandit. Need I say more from this reaction? 99, Blue Tornado. I came off that ride wondering if my ears were still intact because of the amount of headbanging. 98, Hero, Tortured Device, The Ride. 97, Indiana Jones. From the one ride I had on it when I was younger, I don't want to ride it now I'm older. 96, The Ultimate. It was made and manufactured by a train rail company. I shall say no more. 95, Stampeder Blue. Rough. 94, Stampeder Red. Not as rough, but still rough. 93, El Diablo. What a pointless ride. 92, Infusion. It looks quite nice, but doesn't take away from how painful it is. 91, Goodrix. It looks nice as well, but it's just shit. And 90, Rattlesnake. I've said it before, and I'll say it again, destroy it. 89, Cobra. Whiplash. 88, MP Express. Yikes. 87, Energus. Quite funny, to be fair. 86, Boomerang. Inventive name. 85, Runaway Mine Train. Choo-choo. 84, Roller Coaster. Also a very good name. 83, Accelerator. Ben 10 was better. 82, Shaman. It's all right. 81, Steeplechase. Fun as hell. 80, Nickelodeon Streak. Orange. 79, Mighty Mini Mega. I can't pronounce that name all the time. 78, Mammoth. A B-Tech Expedition Everest. 77, Calamity Mine. That's on Rollercoaster Tycoon 2. 76, Big Dipper. It's okay. 75, Speed Water Coaster. Wet. 74, Hollywood Rip Ride Rocket. Music. 73, Walking Dead The Ride. Why? 72, Mayan. It's okay. 71, Big Thunder Mountain, Florida. I don't remember it too well, that's why it's so low down. 70, Sequoia Magic Loop. 69, Vampire. It's not amazing. 68, Raptor Attack. I love that ride. 67, Rake. Very fun. 66, Grand National. Also fun, sometimes. 65, Avalanche, Bobsled. 64, Kumali, the smoothest SLC in the country. 63, Mumbo Jumbo. What the hell? 62, La Trace de Hurrah. Oh, I got that wrong, but Bobsled 2. 61, Journey to Atlantis. Wet, but themed. 60, Heidi the Ride. It does nothing, but it's good. 59, RMF Dragon. It's a hidden gem. 58, Spinball Whizzer. 57, Velocity. Yorkshire's Tron. 56, Rage. Southend Saw. 55, Colossus. Get new trains, please. 54, Tiki Wacker. Very enjoyable. 53, Big One. Also enjoyable. 52, Colorado Adventure. Absolutely amazing. 51, Wild Mouse XXL. I don't even have a note for that one. Mouse. Number 50, Big Thunder Mountain Paris. Good ride. 49, Shockwave. I stood up on a roller coaster. 48, Rita. Shock Horror. 47, Wingersphere and Force. Very unique. 46, Dragon's Fury. Fast as hell. 45, Revolution. Scary as hell. 44, Cobra's Curse. Fun as hell. 43, 13. I wish it was longer. 42, Oblivion. That could also be longer. 41, Storm Chaser. Very well themed. Number 40, Galactica. Relaxing. 39, Movie Park Studio Tour. So good. 38, Anubis. Powerful launch. 37, Revenge of the Mummy. Fire. 36, Olympia Looping. 35, Furious Paco. Rough, but amazing. 34, Formula. 33, Expedition Everest. Oh no. 32, Gringotts. Better than Forbidden Journey, may I add. 31, Kraken. Flawless roller coaster. Number 30, Star Trek. Very smooth. 29, Nemesis Inferno. The worst one. 28, Van Helsing's Factory. Very underrated. 27, Saw the Ride. Well rated. 26, Osiris. I can't remember it too well, so it probably would be higher. 25, Kumba. Loop Round Lift Hill. 24, Dragon Khan. No Loop Round Lift Hill. 23, The Swarm. 22, Stealth. The acceleration is on a mad one. 21, Wicker Man. The experience is unbeatable in the UK. Number 20, Raptor. Really good. Number 19, Black Mamba. Terrain heavy. Number 18, Oblivion the Black Hole. I love that ride. 17, She-Cra. I only had one ride on it, but it was bloody well good. 16, Montu. Again, had one ride on it. It was amazing. 15, Hulk. 14, Nemesis. Gone, but still a favourite. 13, The Smiler. Crazy, but yeah, it's just crazy. 12, Cheetah Hunt. I don't know why I like it so much, but it's there. 11, Icon/Enzo. Icon is so much fun, but Enzo just puts it that notch above. And we are on to the top 10. Yes, it's time. At number 10, we have Manta at SeaWorld Orlando, a B&M flying roller coaster where you go like this. It's a very fun ride, and one element I can remember in particular is, of course, that pretzel loop. At number 9, we have my profile picture. Yep, my profile picture is number 9 on my top 10. I don't know why it's still my profile picture. Red Force at Ferrari Land, Portaventura World. The speed and height of this ride is insane. Like, I've never known a ride like it. There's many out there like it, but you know what I mean. At number 8, we have another SeaWorld Orlando coaster, Mako. Yes, the purple B&M Hyper. I don't know why I specified it was purple. The airtime it has is amazing, other than that trim break, because f*** you. And one time, my body slammed so hard back into the restraint after an airtime hill, I couldn't feel my chest. At number 7, we have Hyperion at Energylandia, an Intamin hypercoaster. This ride is super unique, from the train design to the station design, and especially because it has this really tall inversion. It's a lot of fun. At number 6, we have Conda. Oh, a new entry to the list. This is Walibi Belgium's new Intamin mega coaster, and it is such a good ride from the way it goes through its elements. It's a bit slow in some places, but I think it's meant to be. That ending, though, just makes it for me. And we move on to the top 5. What a beautiful day it is. This video is taking too long. At number 5, we have Shambhala at Portaventura. What an amazing ride. Said that for every single one. The ejector airtime hill, the splashdown, everything. It's one of my favourite rides, and I love it so much. At number 4, we have FLY. Fly at Phantasialand. This is the world's first double launch flying coaster by Vekoma, and the theming on it makes it 10 times better than it would be without it. But it's not as good as number 3, which is Taran in the same park, Phantasialand. I've never ridden a ride 39 times in 3 days, other than Taran. Again, like with Fly, the amount of theming around it just makes that entire ride experience 10 times better. It's an amazing ride nonetheless. And we move on to the top 2 rides. Now, this has been very hard to try and decide, but by my logic, I think I've actually done it in the right order. So at number 2 is Zadra at Energylandia. Yes, it used to be my number 1. It no longer is. This RMC hybrid coaster, the only one I've ever done until later this year, is so fast and packed with elements that it's just an amazing ride overall. One of my favorite elements on the ride is how it banks up and quickly banks outwards and banks you back round again. That element is beyond insane. And that first drop on the back row, how does that exist? How's it legal? Talking of rides that feel illegal, that brings me nicely onto the number 1 spot. And it is, of course, a brand new ride that I rode last year. I can't believe it's last year, 2022, went so fast. Ride to Happiness at Plopsaland, the Mack Extreme spinning coaster with 2 launches. I have never got off a ride after doing it 5 times, every single time getting off it and going, what just happened? Every experience I had on that ride was completely different to the last, and just everything about it is so... I have just ranked 100 roller coasters. What's happening? I've talked about some amazing rides today, but if you want to see us ride some of the craziest rides in London, click here.